when the umpires blow their whistle for an infringement, so there is no wasted time while the umpires discuss a foul. There are quite a few rules in polo. Most of them are for the safety of the ponies. And rather than try and explain them all to you, I'll just explain them as they happen. But of course, as many of you know who've been here before, the main rule of polo is the team that scores the most goals wins. And we can all handle that one. And then I'll get the other rules as we go along. Polo is played four a side, and the players are conveniently numbered 1, 2, 3, and 4. The number one being the attacking player, the number two, the attacking midfield player, the number three, the sort of the generally the better player, the midfield general. He sort of usually dictates the direction and the speed and the tactics of his team. And the number four is the defensive player, trying to stop the opposing number one. You'll see they will pair off against each other. The number one marks the attacking player, will mark the other team's defensive player, and so on. The one, the four, the two, the three, the two, and the four, the one. They're allowed to ride each other off. That's bump each other to prevent the opposition from getting to the ball. They must be at a safe angle and at the same speed. They're allowed to hook each other's sticks if they can prevent the other guy from hitting the ball. Those polo sticks are made of a type of bamboo with a very hardwood head. They're generally about 50, 52 inches long. So you can imagine it's fairly difficult hitting a polo ball 51 inches away while you're galloping along and it's bouncing around the grass. And talking about bouncing around the grass, at half time after the third chucker, the polo tradition is to come onto the field and tread in. So we'd love it if you go and divot stomp, tread in. Makes it a lot easier for the players to hit the ball if it's running true along the grass. As I mentioned, the two umpires, they're the guys in the middle with the stripy shirts. And then the other confusing thing of polo, or of horses actually, a bit like sailing where they have starboard and port as opposed to left and right, horses don't have left and right either. They have the offside for right and the near side for left. So I'll be saying offside shot or a near side shot. That means the left or the right. I have no idea why you can't use left and right like the rest of the civilized world, but horsey people want to be like boaty people and be different. So the Boston team are in the blue with a white stripe, and I believe they're representing the Shriv, Crump and Lowe company today. So have a jolly good match. In the number one position, let's introduce our guests, is Dave Strauss. In the number two position, Whitney Ellis. In the number three position, Carlos Coles. Lovely to have him back again. And in the number four position, hopefully the best player on the pitch, Nick Snow. Watch out for him, ladies and gentlemen. And the home team, let's get a better round of applause. We're not getting much going on right now, is young Charlie Bullis. In the number two position, that damn president of ours, that damn Keating. In the number three position, Rory Torrey. And a back, great to have him back on our Saturday afternoon field, Jimmy DeAngelis, recovered from a tendon injury, so it's nice to have him back. So, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding, and gentlemen, remove your hats. We'll have our national anthem. Thank you very much indeed. All right, let's get the game on. The team's change ends after every goal scored. Not at halftime, not after each chucker, but after every goal. So you have to keep an eye on which team is going in which direction. And right now, we're going to have Boston going up towards the NBC Channel 10 scoreboard. And the ball is thrown in by Sam Clements. It's a bit of a fight at the moment between Carlos Coles and Dan Keating. Dan Keating won that on the Grey Pony, sending the ball up for Newport. But in defence is Nick Snow. Nick, lovely cut back, and what a pass. Look at that. He found Carlos just waiting for him. Carlos, little lofted shot up to the 60-yard line. Dan Keating trying to ride him off. A good backhander from Rory Torrey. Runs into Charlie Bullis. Charlie can't really do anything with it. And it looks like Nick Snow coming through. No, that's not. I'm sorry, that was Dave Strauss. But a good backhand from Charlie. Passing to Rory Torrey. Rory taking off now. The number three for Newport. Rory still got it. Nick Snow keeping an eye on him. Rory can't get the next shot. Now it's Carlos. Carlos. It's Coles. Gets the backhand. Trying to find Whitney Ellis. Ellis gets a little touch, but Keating intercepts and picks up. Keating on that lovely horse, Sugar, that grey pony that Minnie loves to play. Charlie Bullis backing him up. Doesn't do quite enough. Dave Strauss gets a little backhand pass to Whitney Ellis, who tries to go under the neck to find his number four, Nick Snow, but it's intercepted. And a great hook from Nick Snow, but they leave the ball for Rory. Rory Torrey, oh, doesn't quite control his tap. He's still got it, though. He's still going forward. Oh, Nick Snow just snuck in there with a nearside backhander, but Jimmy DeAndres, oh, welcome to the game, Jimmy. Jimmy DeAndres gets it, sends the ball at goal. It's looking a little wide at the moment. He's got another tap, a backhand off the line by Nick Snow. Nick Snow trying to find Carlos Coles. Coles sends the ball up. Whitney Ellis has another go at it. It's still there. Whitney on the near side now sends it a little further up, trying to get to Dave Strauss. Doesn't manage it. Rory Torrey, tailed backhander. What a pass to Jimmy DeAndres. Ooh. Jimmy didn't quite what he wanted, and Nick Snow getting across the field, turning it upfield now, under lovely control on that lovely looking pony of his. Now he's going to cut it towards the middle. He does. Rory Torrey, though, in defence. Rory's going to bring it across the field. Rory looking up, just pulling up his pony, taps it once, looks upfield. Charlie Bullis is waiting for him. Can he get the ball to Charlie? Oh, he's just gone a little towards the centre. Charlie's got there, though. Well played, Charlie. He's going to try and bring it up the field. Doesn't manage it. Backhand from Whitney Ellis just to Nick Snow. Nick sees Carlos Cole over there on his own. Going to try and catch him is Jimmy DeAndres. He beats Jimmy to it. Now he's going to try and run it along the back line. Little tap there. Well played. Carlos Coles. Carlos. Carlos. He's just got to get it under the pony. He does. And it sneaks over the goal line for the first goal of the day to Boston. Good play from both teams. It's lovely when you've got a good open game of polo with not many fouls. Fouling just stops the game all the time. So far, this has been great. Rory Torrey's just got off his pony. It looks like it might be a tack issue. So we're very happy to stop the clock and just give Rory time to adjust whatever it is. Excellent. So the teams will line up in front of umpire Sam Clements. And remember, they've changed ends. So Boston will be going down towards the pony lines. The red of Newport going up towards the NBC Channel 10 scoreboard. And Sam throws it in between the two of them. It bounces out in favour of Boston. And quickly onto it is Nick Snow. Nick just pulling up his pony. His two attacking players have made a move up in front of him. Nick on the near side now. Can he get it? He's still got it. Charlie Bullis trying to get to him. Oh, what a shot, but he's cut it across the face of the goal. And so we'll have a hit in to Newport. Umpire's call play. Boston have to be 30 yards into the field. And a lovely little pass to Charlie Bullis. Oh, he doesn't take it, though. That's a bad error by Charlie. He doesn't make many of them. And the number one, Dave Strauss, picks it up. Dave leaves it behind. Whitney Ellis tries to pick it up, backhand there by Charlie. Jimmy DeAndres onto it. Jimmy just taps it around, trying to look upfield. Needs to go a little faster. Charlie's running up the field for him, but already in defence, the number four for Boston. Nick Snow is there. Nick, good backhander from him, but it's picked up brilliantly by Rory Torrey. Rory Torrey on the attack now. Charlie, don't get in his way. Rory, he's going to get to it. Oh, look, he's going to be ridden off by Whitney. What a lovely ride off. Somehow Torrey's still got it. It's still in play. Can he get the backhand? Oh, no, he couldn't. Whitney couldn't get it. Huge backhand from Charlie Bullis, and I think it runs into one of the Boston players and runs over the back line. So I think it will be a hit in. I think the whistle did go, so maybe the umpires are just discussing. Maybe it came off the stick of the Boston player. So if it comes off the stick of the defending player, in this case the Boston player, we have the equivalent of what you would get in soccer as a corner when the defending player puts the ball over his own back line. Rather unfortunate for the Boston player in this time because it just deflected off him. So the polo equivalent of a soccer corner is the ball will be put on the 60-yard line opposite where it went over the back line. So it's not in the middle of the field, it's slightly off to the, in this case, towards the flag side. And Boston will defend this. They've got to be 30 yards from the ball, but they'll be between the ball and the posts. And Rory Torrey, the number three for Newport, will take it. Dan, Keating and Charlie Bullis, either sides of the goalposts. In case it's going wide, they will try and deflect it into the middle again. And here comes Rory. Looks like he's going for the big shot. He's got one away. It's going. Oh, it runs into Charlie. And I would say that that man, Nick Snow, has got the defence. And he not only has he got the defence, but he's got a great pass up to the halfway line for Dave Strauss. Bouncing ball on him. Whitney Ellis over the top of it as well. Dan Keating trying to get the backhand. Just enough to reach Jimmy DeAngis. Now Jimmy needs the backhand because there's two Newport players right there. They're in the open. There's three of them behind each other. Surely they can do something with this. Rory. Dan, get out of his way. Rory going forward. No, it comes off his cane. And in defence, Nick Snow gets the backhand up the field. Jimmy DeAngelis needs to play it on the near side. He does. Gets the backhand away. Only as far as that. Nick Snow again. Nick Snow just directs the ball across the field. So he's got the right to play it again. Now he needs to get the pass away. Little lofted shot up the field. Carlos Cole's trying to get to it. Dan beat him to it. It's coming across the field. Rory's called Charlie off it. Rory's going across the field. Looking under the neck. 2 minutes to go. Rory's got the one tap. Now he's got one more to go. Yes, he has. He's still got it. There's no play there. Still Rory Torrey going forward. It's underneath the ponies. Charlie Bullis has got it. Charlie has got it this time. And Charlie Bullis puts it through. All even, one all. Great play from Rory Torrey for Charlie Bullis. But Charlie had to do the work of putting it through the posts. Those height limits the goal posts in polo, so you can go high as you like, as long as it's within the 8 yard span of the goalposts. So in comes the ball. Newport are going down towards the pony lines. And Rory Torrey fighting for it, comes out with it, just tapping it around again. Going around the outside of umpire Dave Bullis. Rory sends the ball into the middle of the field. Where is it? Who's got it? It looks like Rory's going to get onto it again. Rory sends a shot at goal. Has he got the direction? He's got the distance, but he hasn't quite got the direction. It's still in play, though, and Charlie Bullis backs it right into the middle of the goal area, very invitingly, but Carlos Cole's in defence for Boston. Gets it out of the way. Dan Keating on the grey pony. Puts it straight back in the middle. Comes off Charlie Bullis. No, I'm sorry, that was Jimmy DeAngelis. Jimmy now trying to send it back into the middle. Doesn't really get the shot he wanted. Dan Keating sneaks it in front of Dave Strauss, but now it comes back again. Rory Torrey. Gosh, they're all fighting really hard, and there goes the 30-second bell. Rory's still got it. Can he cut it? It's bouncing. Rory, oh, he bounced it into the middle. Oh, I don't believe that from, oh, what a backhand by Nick Snow, literally off the goal line. That was a certain goal for Newport, but Nick Snow in defence, that's what the number four is supposed to do. And who's picking it up now? Nick Snow again. He's looking upfield. He's waiting for Carlos to make a run. He's got Whitney making a run in the middle. There it comes. There it goes. There it is. Dan Keating's on it, though. Dan Keating, little backhander on the grey pony, little tail. And that ends the first chucker. And what a lovely chucker it was, too. I think there might have been just one foul in the whole thing. And it's nice to get a good flowing game of polo.